What's up? My name is Jawny, formerly known as Jawny Utah. I live in Los Angeles, California. I was born in the Bay Area. I used to live in Philadelphia. I used to live in a fried chicken place as well when I was cooking there. I make love boy pop music. I make carnival funk music. I make bad music and I make good music. And this is my interview. You got the funk, gets me stupid, gets me drunk. I'll do anything that you want, anything that you want. I wouldn't say I grew up in a super musical family. Everyone in my family liked music though, loved music. My mom loves music, always blasting music. My dad the same way. I kind of like on my own, like always really wanted to play guitar and be like a musician. Like I was like obsessed with like live concert, like DVD box sets of like Kiss and like Queen and all these like artists, because I just like was obsessed with like performers on stage, and I always wanted to do it, but I never thought I actually would. So it's kind of crazy to think that all these years later that I'm doing it for my job now. It's a little weird because like you can ask my mom and even she gets a little freaked out too, because she's like, you've literally always wanted to do this since you were like a kid. Like this is all you've ever wanted to do, and now I'm doing it and it's fucking beautiful. My first start in music, where I was just playing musical instruments, I was probably like 6 when I started playing the guitar. I never did lessons or anything, but I just like picked it up and just fell in love with it. But then like my first time like making music, where like it was like music being made and like putting it on the internet type stuff, I feel like I was like 14 or 15 when I started making like beats for like internet rappers. I was trying to be a beat boy. I was trying to be a beat rapper boy, but I ended up not doing that. And now about like 19 or 20 years old, I started making like my own music with like my vocals on it and stuff, which I never thought I would do, because like I was always super insecure about it, because I sing in like a higher pitched octave normally, which is not what boys my age normally did where I was from. I felt like they were all gonna make fun of me. And then I built up enough courage to like release my first like official like real song at like 21. So I was a late bloomer. Yeah, I got myself a floaty. That's the first one that I've drank in since I'm sober. Oh no. Yeah, I hadn't heard from you since the last time that you drunk texted me, come over. And she said, hey, with a smiley face. 107 a.m. Texas booty calling me. I don't want your late night loving, staying at your place. I just wanna be the one that you want in the day. I did drop out of college and I did manage a pizzeria in New Jersey. A super, super high energy, like very high energy, to where the point where you get off work and you're just like decompressing a little bit and your eyes are kind of like open wide because you're still like wired. You're like on a little bit. And then eventually I couldn't do that anymore because it was like kind of unhealthy to my mental health. I would wake up at like 6 in the morning. No, I'd wake up at 4:30 in the morning, go to work at 6. Work from like 6 to like 3 or 4, get off of work, take like a 2 or 3 hour nap, start making music at like 8 o'clock at night, make music till like 2 or 3 in the morning, go to bed at like 3:30 and wake up at 4:30 the next morning, just tired as hell. And that was like my life, because I loved music, but I also had to work to make money. And it was kind of hell, like a little bit. But there's also something beautiful about it, because it kind of like makes you really sad sometimes, but sometimes like really good music comes out of being sad. And so, like, I attribute, like, a lot of my older music to, like, being just, like, super stressed out. But then, like, I like my music that I made while I was stressed out. I feel like my music has been classified as bedroom pop a lot because, obviously, I make music in my bedroom. But it's weird because I feel like there's a lot of music that's made not in the bedroom and made in a studio that people still call bedroom pop. So I have no idea where the line is on what it's called. I don't think my music is bedroom pop, so I don't know. Other people just call it bedroom pop and I go along with it, but like I feel like the music I make is just genuine to me, and it's just comes from like my experiences and how I feel inside. And I guess that may differ from another artist who's talking from their experience or their outlook. I'd like to think that it's different, but it also might not be that different. I don't know. I think I try to make cool music. I hope it comes out as cool. That would be cool if it came out as cool. And if somebody out there thinks that it's cool, then I think they're cool. Oh girl, won't you stop till you get enough, huh? Oh honey, honey pie, honey, honey, honey pie. Oh girl, won't you stop till you get enough, huh? Oh honey, honey pie, honey.
success with Honey Pie was something I thought I was gonna get from a song that I released before. I thought it was like my magna opus. I was like, this is the best song I've ever made. I'll never make a better song than this. And I released it and like nobody cared about it at all. Like I spent like 2 months like perfecting this. I got like live trumpets tracked on it. I got live piano track. I wrote all these crazy parts. I thought it was amazing. And then it just kind of like didn't do what I thought I was gonna do. And it really messed with my head a lot. And so then I had this other song, Honey Pie, and I'm happy that everybody enjoyed it because it, I don't know, it like changed my life kind of. The hook had no meaning at all. I just thought it sounded really cool. And then through the verses, I had wrote it so that it could kind of tell a story so that it wasn't so meaningless. So it turned into like a song about a boy just like wanting a girl to like be his. That's like pretty much it, which probably stemmed from like me wanting to be in a relationship really bad at the time. Because I think I was feeling lonely. And single Jacob is a different person than relationship Jacob. Some like special goal that I would have for like my musical career would definitely be, right now I'm like 24 and I'm living very comfortably making music. It would be awesome if when I'm 30, I was still living comfortably making music. And then it would be even awesomer if when I was 35, I was still living comfortably making music. And so on and so forth. That would obviously be the ideal goal and the dream. I feel like I could come up with a lot of other answers. That's, it just seems weird though to be like, oh, I wish I want to play this festival, or I want to have this spot, or I want to make a song with this person, because those just feel like the wrong things to like dream about, you know? Because my thing is just I want to like live comfortably and be able to like support my family on music, like for more than just right now in my early 20s. Because right now I'm good and everything's gravy, but then like in 2 or 3 years it's like, I hope that I can still be up to par and like remain relevant in like an industry that's constantly changing, where new music is constantly coming out and it's very easy to be forgotten about. Super easy to be forgotten about. Which is like a fear I think everybody has. So let's hope I don't get forgotten.